Hello students, and welcome back to the Curiosity Kingdom. Today is the first science lecture and we are going to study biology, and our topic is cell structure and function. Two important announcements. Now we are on Twitter at Curiosity Kingdom Official, and also at Quora, search for my ID Atharv Dubey and log in with that, in which there is a Curiosity Kingdom logo. Follow us over there. Now let's start. So you all know basic things about cell. That cells are basic building block of life. Every organism is made up of cell. Okay, so now let's start. So first, we should know the discovery of cell, how it was discovered. So the cell was discovered by Robert Hooke in 1665. What he did, he took a piece of cork and observed it under a microscope. What he actually saw were dead cells of cork. But this was the point when cell was discovered. Much after the discovery, not much more inventions or detailed study has been done because they were not good microscopes. But when improved microscopes came, much more research has been done. At present, if you see, there are very improved microscopes like the electron microscope, which can magnify images up to 2 lakh times. Okay, so now let's see the cell theory. So what happened in 1838, two German biologists, namely Matthias Kaldin and the other Schwann, put forward a theory which was named as the cell theory. Some points of this theory are as follows: that all living things are made up of cell, just as a building is made up of a bricks. Okay, so they are the basic building block of life. Similarly, just like a building or a wall is made up of bricks, similarly an organism is made up of cells. Hence they are called the building block of life or living organism, and they are the complex living structures. This is the first point. The second point is that all cells are similar in their basic structure but are not identical. They have a similar basic structure, like we have our hands, legs and so on. Okay, but not everyone is identical. Similar is the case here. The next is that new cells are formed by division in old cells. This is known as cell division. We learn about it later. The next is organization of cell determines the structure of a living organism. Means the way the cells are organized in a body, like the way we organize bricks in a wall, determines the structure of the wall. Similar is the case over here. The next thing is the way an organism functions depends on the way the cell works. Okay, so see, if a particular group of cells started malfunctioning, so the organ or the part they belong will also start malfunctioning, and hence the organism will get affected. Hence, the way the organism works depends on the way the cells work. Okay, so hope this is clear. Now I move further, but before that, if you want to know how interest is calculated in banks, then do see the video. The link is in the description. And if you want to increase your general knowledge, then do see my video on 15 GK questions to increase your GK. The link is in the description. Now let's move further. At the classification or the differentiation of organism on the basis of number of cells. Okay, there are two such classifications, the unicellular and multicellular. Let's learn about them. First, we'll talk about unicellular. So, organisms that are made of one cell, you can understand from the name uni, means one. So, the organisms which are made up of one cell are known as unicellular organism. Example, algae and paramecium. They are made up of just one cell, but they perform all activities that are necessary for life. Means they do all the things that a living creature does and which are required to live. Like they grow, they move, they digest, they excrete, and even reproduce. Okay, so an example you can see over here, amoeba, which is a unicellular organism. It has no definite shape. Okay, so this was unicellular organism. Now we come to multicellular organism. So what happens, like organism like we humans, tigers, birds and so on, are not made of just one single cell. We are made up of many cells. We can be seen from naked eyes. Okay, like we can't see unicellular organism mostly from our naked eyes. Okay, hence we are known as multicellular organism. Means multi means many. Okay, so in multicellular organism, what happens, there are different level of organization. So it starts from a cell which combine to form a tissue, like in plants that dermal tissue, vascular tissue. A group of tissues combine to form an organ, like in human body, if you can say stomach, small intestine, large intestine. A group of organs combine to form an organ system, like our stomach, and all these combine to form our digestive system. And when different organ system combine, like the circulatory system, nervous system, digestive system, respiratory system, all these combine, they form an organism. So in organism, we know that one particular cell does not perform all life functions. There are different cells, and each cell has a specific function, so it is designed accordingly. Like the nerve cells have fibers which are more than 1 meter long just to transmit signals, whereas our muscle cells keep relaxing and contracting, hence they are long and thin. Similarly, our white blood cells have the ability to change their shape so that they can go through the intercellular spaces of an organism to kill the germs or pathogens. Okay, so this was about multicellular organism. Hope it might be clear. Now move forward to the structure of a typical cell. You might have remembered this statement that they are similar in their basic structure. So we'll learn that basic structure only. Okay, so the basic structure, it contains the cytoplasm, cell membrane, nucleus and organelles. So this is the diagram of the cell. Okay, I will refer it for you to better understand the chapter. So first is cytoplasm. So this cell is filled up with a jelly-like substances that makes most of the inside of the cell. This substance is known as cytoplasm. All life functions take place within the cytoplasm. Okay. Next is cell membrane. So this layer that separates the cytoplasm from its surrounding is known as the cell membrane. Its function is to separate it from the surroundings, protect it and give it a shape. Okay, it is porous. This means that it allows the passing of certain materials like the molecules of food, water and mineral. It is also known as the plasma membrane. Okay, these are some key terms. Now I move forward to another thing, that is nucleus. This is very important in a cell. So like in our body, brain is really important as it controls our body. Similarly in a cell, nucleus is very important as it controls the cell. Hence it is often called the brain of the cell. It directs the growth of the cell and all functions within the cell. Okay. This nucleus is filled with a substance or a jelly-like substance. Again, this name is nucleoplasm. And this nucleoplasm is separated from this cytoplasm by a membrane which is called the nuclear membrane. This nuclear membrane is again porous, means it allows the transfer or the exchange of things between the cytoplasm and the nucleoplasm. Okay, and a ball-like structure which you can see in the center of this nucleus is known as the nucleolus. Okay, this was the basic structure. In addition to this, there are chromosomes. So chromosomes are nothing but small thread-like structures that carry genes. Genes contain the crucial information that are required for the cell to function and to produce the cell of the new kind. Genes are the unit of inheritance. What is inheritance? The transfer of specific functions or the specific things from the parents to the offspring. Okay. The nucleus and the cytoplasm. This nucleus and the cytoplasm together form the protoplasm, which is considered to be the living substance of the cell. Okay. This protoplasm is made of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen and other substances. Okay. Hope this might be clear. Now we come to another thing, that is organelles. So what are organelles? Organelles are specific things that do a specific function. A different type of organelles. First is mitochondria. So whenever during assimilation the food comes in our body, okay, in our cells as molecules of food, what happens? It goes to the mitochondria and there it is oxidized and we get energy. Okay, so mitochondria are small rod-like structure that provide energy. Next is vacuoles. What are vacuoles? Vacuoles are sac-like structure. They store food, water and waste. They are mostly found in plants. In animals also they are found. Okay. Next is plastids. Plastids are organelles present in plants. There are different types. Okay. So a green color plastid you might all have heard about is chloroplast, which contains chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is really important for earth. You know that it produces all the food. Without chlorophyll, food can't be produced. With chlorophyll, a process known as photosynthesis happens, through which the plants can make food. Okay. In addition to them, there are Golgi bodies which secrete substances like enzymes, endoplasmic reticulum, which helps in the transport of substances within the cell. In addition, there are ribosomes which make protein, lysosomes which destroy cells. So whenever a cell dies, maybe because of long time or maybe some hurt or even because of pathogen, so they are destroyed, or their dead bodies are destroyed by lysosomes. They are suicide squads. And finally our centrosomes, they regulate cell division. Okay, so these are organelles and the basic structure ends over here. So before we move forward, if you want to know 10 really amazing facts, do watch the video. The link is in the screen. So let's move further. Types of cells. So there are two types of cells. One is a eukaryotic cell and the other is a prokaryotic cell. So in eukaryotic cell, what is there? That there is a nuclear membrane. Okay. And the cell is organized. Like in humans, there are eukaryotic cells. Means the cell is properly organized. Such cells are called eukaryotes. Eukaryotic cells and the organism that have such cells are called eukaryotes. Okay, whereas on the other side, prokaryotic cells don't have a nuclear membrane. So what happens, the nucleus completely spread around the cytoplasm. So hence the cell is not well organized. Such types of cells are known as prokaryotic cells. Organisms with such cells are known as prokaryote. Example, blue-green algae. Okay, so hope this might be clear. Now we move further on the difference between plant and animal cell. Okay, so plants and animals have different cells. We'll learn about them. So first is that plant cells are larger than animal cell. Okay, plants have big cells than animal cells, where animal cells are smaller. In both plant and animal cells, there is a cell membrane. But in plant cell, there is also a cell wall. So what happened in plant, there is no skeleton system to give the plant support. Like in humans, we have a skeleton system of 206 bones. But in plants, there is not. So that the plant could stand upright, there is an additional layer or an additional cover in the cell of plants, which is known as cell wall. It gives the plant a rigidity and helps it stand upright. Okay, the next is they have one or two large vacuoles so that they can store food, whereas there is absence of, or they are very small. Because humans don't need to store, they get and they need energy, whereas plants of continuously start keep producing food. So they need space to store the extra food. Next is there are different types of plastic, like I told you, chloroplast, but in animals there are no chloroplasts and no plastids. Okay, they don't have centrosome, whereas we humans have centrosome. What the centrosomes do? They regulate cell division. Okay, now I'll move further, but before that, if you want to know more about the channel Curiosity Kingdom, do watch the introductory video, the link is in the description. Now move to cell division. So see what happens after reaching a critical size, a cell could not grow more. Okay. So then it divides itself to two new cells. This process is known as cell division. The new cell thus formed is known as the daughter cell. And the cell from which the new cell was formed is known as the mother cell. Okay, so now I'll tell you how it happens. So see, a cell is there, it reaches its critical size. So now what will happen? It will start splitting up. Okay, so first the nucleus divides into two. And when the nucleus divides properly, the cell membrane and the cytoplasm also starts dividing into two parts. And after this process complete, two completely new cells are formed, which is known as the cell division. And one cell is known as the daughter cell and the other is known as the mother cell. Okay, why do we need new cells? Because the cells die after a particular time. Even when you fall down, cells die. And because of pathogens and germs, cells die. Okay, so to replace those cells, we need new cells. Most of the cells in human body is replaced except the cells of nervous system. Thus, it is really risky if you get a hurt in your nervous system, like in the brain or in the spinal cord. Okay, whereas if you get a fracture in your hand, you get a plaster. After that, our body or our cells themselves recover over there. But in nervous system, it is not the thing. So now, since you have watched the video till end, there are some star facts. Okay, I'll tell you. So, an egg of a bird is considered to be one single cell. Okay. So, hence the largest cell is the egg of the eagle. And the egg of the eagle is quite big. Even you can see an egg of a hen, which you often consume, is just one single cell. Okay. The next is that the smallest cell is the bacterial cell. And the largest cell in the human body is the red blood cell or the RBCs. There's one really important and really interesting factor known as the rhesus factor in RBCs. If you want to know more about it and also about the rarest blood type, then do watch our 10 Amazing Facts series video. The link is in the description. So now by this we come to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. Please like this video. It takes a lot of effort to create such a video. Don't forget to subscribe this channel for more such interesting videos. We'll soon be presenting our next videos like on facts in GK and on interesting topics. And please send your reviews either in the Google form, given in the description or in the comment box below. Don't forget to follow us at Twitter at Curiosity Kingdom Official or at Quora at Atharv with the logo of Curiosity Kingdom. Thank you for watching and God bless you all.